Like many of you, I'm excited about new technologies. Take Facebook, for example, and my presentation. Thank you. Take Facebook, for example. You can use it to keep in touch with each other all over the world, but you can also use it for cyberbullying, for breaking up relationships, for making people lose their jobs, and even it can even be responsible for cases of teen suicide. So is Facebook good or is it bad? I say it depends on the discretion of the users. Now, I'm passionate about future technologies. I've been researching it in the university for years. I'm writing blog posts, I'm writing papers, I'm even publishing a book right now about emerging technologies. I talk with early adopters, with analyzers, with developers, with entrepreneurs. And I try to identify and analyze emerging technologies that we can and should embrace. But I always remember that we must consider them very, very carefully. Because if we don't, technology can backfire on us. Let me show you an example. Meet my son, Roey Tzezana. Gorgeous, isn't he? Absolutely. In 2 weeks, he will celebrate his first birthday. Let us follow 3 possible scenarios into the future and see how technology can be used to shape his life in the 3 decades to come. 10 years from now, Roey is 11 years old. I watch him sleep and I smile. Why am I smiling? Because he's not schizophrenic. You see, in the next 5 years, genetic sequencing is going to cost less than $1,000. That means you can sequence, you can read the entire genetic code of a human being for a measly sum of money. Roey is going to have his entire genetic code sequenced, meaning doctors are going to read every gene in his genome and analyze its implications. And it turns out, Roey is prone to schizophrenia. But he hasn't had an episode yet. And even that is something for me to smile about. I drive Roey to school, to his private school. It wasn't easy to get in. Unlike public schools, private schools require a genetic certificate. And when the school board read Roey's genetic certificate, they almost disqualified him on the spot. Luckily, his grades were high enough to grant him entry anyway. But his friend David wasn't as lucky. His gene map showed the potential for uncontrollable fits of rage. They never happened even once, but he still got rejected. Because in 10 years from now, we'll be entering the era of genomic fashion, where friends share their genetic data over Facebook. Oh, sorry, over a gene book. And Roey shared his genetic data with all of his friends, and now he really regrets it because everyone in his class knows. This is not science fiction. The technology for sequencing your entire genome already exists, and they will get much, much cheaper in the next few years. 20 years from now, Roey is 21 years old. Please stop with the whistling. I watch him sleep, and I smile. Why am I smiling? Because he is still not schizophrenic. Also, I think of his beautiful eyes. I paid for one of them. How did that happen? Well, you know about 3D printers, right? This amazing technology that can be used to print items and tools in your house. It's amazing technology. It's exciting. It's full of potential and benefits. But it also depends. Unless we use tough regulation and strict discretion, these printers are going to hurt some people, like Roey. Because when he is a teenager, he's curious. And I leave him home alone. He goes to the internet and he downloads the schematic for an actual gun. And he prints this gun on the internet, in his printer, with a bullet immediately printed in the gun ready to be fired. And again, not science fiction, guys. These weapons have been printed, 3D printed, in 2013, this year, the magazine and the body of the rifle. And it is, the rifle has been used to shoot 6 bullets before it malfunctioned. When Omer is a teenager, he will download the gun, he will print it, he will take the gun out. Well, he aims it at the window. He pulls the trigger, and the gun doesn't fire. The bullet must be stuck. So he aims it at the computer screen, right in front of him. And he pulls the trigger, and the gun still doesn't fire. The bullet must be really stuck. And then he decides to find out exactly where the bullet is stuck. It's a good thing we have insurance, because even in the future, 3D printers that print new eyes are not cheap at all. In 30 years from now, Omer is 31 years old. I watch him sleep, and I smile. Why am I smiling? Because he's 31 years old, and he's still not schizophrenic. It is, in 30 years, it is the era of brain technology. It is the time when technology starts to influence and affect your brain. Think of your brain as a car engine. If you want to switch gears, if you want to take it to the next level and beyond, well, you can't. You don't have a wheel to guide your brain. You don't have the levers. You can't reach inside. Or can you? Because even today, 2013, we have technologies that can be used to boost the brain's performance, to enhance memory creation, to make you think faster. These technologies are based on creating electromagnetic fields inside your brain. There are some neurology and psychology students who even use this technology on themselves by attaching generators to their heads so that the electromagnetic field is created in certain spots and it should help them study better. And they say it does. And that's great, right? I mean, who wouldn't want that? I would want to use this technology. But once you start pulling levers and pushing buttons in the brain, well, it's got to start being messy at some point, because the brain is not a simple organ. You can't just play around with it. And in 30 years, when this technology is as commonplace as cell phones today, some people will exhibit adverse effects. And Omer might be one of those. He will use it for a long time, because he needs to keep up ahead in his job. He has no choice. Everybody else is using it. And at some point, some parts get burned. And now, 30 years from now, he finds it more difficult to accomplish his daily tasks. That's why he still lives at home. Why did I take you on this journey with me? There is a message for all of us here. Technology is here to serve us, to improve our life, but only if we use it carefully and with discretion. I believe we should use more regulation on emerging technologies, some of which I've shown you right now. And this is not science fiction. All of these technologies exist today. I believe we should teach our children to be more responsible in their use of emerging technologies. And I believe we should start today. And I call upon you, each and every one of you, when you finish this conference, when you rise from your computer screen, go to your children and talk with them about the amazing and exciting technologies they are using. 40 years from now, Omer is 41 years old. I watch him sleep, and I thank you for listening to me.